November is the American Diabetes and Diabetic Eye Disease Awareness Month.
Yeah, did you know that? We have an expert coming in to talk more about that when we come back.
Also, we'll be joining Dan Plant in a little bit for the latest situation there along the 5 freeway. We're right back after this.
Back, we are talking about diabetes, which is a leading cause of blindness in the working age American group. And November is American Diabetes and Diabetic Eye Disease Awareness Month. So here to talk with us more is ophthalmologist Dr. Sandy Feldman and cataract patient with diabetes, Sasha Sandusky. Thank you so much for being here with us this morning. Sasha, we were just talking about your situation. You've had diabetes since childhood?
Well, since I was 21. I have had it for 8 years now. And in the first early stages of becoming a diabetic, I was neglecting myself. And I didn't take care of myself. I didn't get a checkup normally. And so I ended up getting cataracts in my eyes, and I couldn't see very well. And so that led to me having to get the cataract surgery, and now I can see very great, and now I'm going to take better care of my eyes.
Well, Dr. Feldman, tell us why that happens with diabetics.
Well, there's a number of different things that happens. The high blood sugar can cause swelling of the lens of our eye, and that can actually change. One of the earliest signs is a change and an increase in the nearsightedness that you have. Other things that happen are that you can damage the blood vessels in the back of the eye. This can lead to swelling in the area that you see the best. So diabetics are at increased risk for many eye diseases.
Now, are there advancements? I know that for a long time, people that were suffering from cataracts didn't have as good of options. But today, it seems like we're in a much better place.
Yeah, today we've got new lasers, a femtosecond laser, that can very precisely and very gently help us to remove cataracts. We also have implantable lenses that we can put in so that you don't need thick glasses and you can get good vision for the distance as well as close up. So cataract surgery has come a long way, in the past number of years.
What is Sasha facing for the future?
So it's important that Sasha undergo eye exams every 6 months, certainly every year, to make sure that the back of her eye, that she doesn't develop something known as diabetic retinopathy. You can get little strokes in the back of the eye. It's also important to monitor her for glaucoma. That's a disease where the pressure inside the eye is high and it can lead to damage of the nerve that will affect one's peripheral vision. So diabetes causes a lot of different things to the eye, all of which aren't good. Earlier diagnosis leads to earlier treatment, leads to preservation of one's vision.
Good, that's wonderful news. Wonderful news for Sasha. Sasha, how do you feel? Is there any pain or discomfort?
Right now, I'm in the early stages. I just got it about a week and a half ago, so I'm a little sensitive to light, and that's normal. Sometimes I get a little frustrated, but it's doing really well. I can see really well. I'm less frustrated. It's very exciting to be able to see again, because before everything was very blurry, and that's hard to live like that.
Right.
But just like she said, get checkup every 6 months, take care of yourself, exercise. I had to stop smoking because smoking is the number one cause of getting eye disease too from diabetics.
So smoking increases your risk. Now the most important thing to do, especially around the holidays, is to think about eating right and exercising. Those two things are really important if you have diabetes or pre-diabetes, because there are 80 million people in the U.S. who have pre-diabetes out there. And they're good for your blood sugar, but also good for your eyes. Both of those things, even if you have no diseases, it's good for your eyes.
Yeah, especially for the holidays, very good point. Make sure that you take a look at that sugar intake this holiday season. There's a lot of pie out there. We know we like those good treats. All right, thank you two for coming here this morning. We'll be back with some more Good Morning San Diego coming up in just a little while.